I made this Lego pinball machine, but these buttons don't do anything.
I will show you how I built it, and I will compare three methods of controlling a pinball machine, ranging from manual to full AI.
So let's lay out how big this thing is gonna be. I think that's the biggest machine I've ever made. So I'm thinking this could be the RAM, and then there could be like a tower behind it with like scores and the camera for the AI. Yeah. So like this is the ramp and this is the back.
Yeah, that should work.
I think I'm just gonna start with some yellow walls and then later add some detail. And that's for my 2x4 yellow Lego bricks. I will most likely have to order Lego for this video. Okay, I'll just make the ramp and then see where that goes. Luckily, I have a lot more of these. So this is so far I got. I guess there could be some flippers like so. And then there will be a small thing along the side that brings the ball back in the game. That should be enough. I think we need another set of bins for this. I may have underestimated how much Lego this actually is. Yeah, I most definitely underestimated it. Wait, I haven't even unpacked this one.
So after I made sure that I definitely had enough Lego to build this machine, I started building up the base of the machine. This meant I made a ramp that would let the ball return to the plunger when it drained from the board, and another ramp that would be able to bring the ball back in the game. Of course, this also means that there needs to be a plunger that must be motorized, since everything must be able to be controlled by the AI.
So I've just been kind of laying things out. So this is going to be the main field where the ball is in game. And then we have this return strip where the ball gets brought back to the plunger and it gets put back into the field over this strip on the side. We need the machine, like the code, to be able to automatically bring the ball back into the game so that it can play another game and learn from itself. And I've got an idea to make this plunger motorized since it's a really small space for a mechanism, but I'll just get to that and then show you.
So that's what I did. I started by designing this lever that would be able to be pushed into the plunger, making it pull back and build up energy. This lever can then be pushed out of the way, releasing all this built up energy. You can clearly see the lever catches the plunger and near the end it is released because it gets pushed off by a diagonal piece before being pushed back into position by another piece.
Although I'm really happy with this mechanism, it does mean that there's not a whole lot of room left for this button here on the side, so I'm gonna have to see if I can fit a touch sender in there somewhere.
After literally tearing it all apart again, I did manage to fit in a touch sender through a series of connected axles. And luckily, the other side caused less of a problem.
I want this flipper to be motorized because this AI needs to be able to control the machine. Because if I just build a flipper like this, that is not fast enough. We need it to be more explosive. Like that. That went way harder than I expected. It smells like gunpowder here now. I expected it more like this. No. Well, yeah. Okay, maybe not really like that, but you get the point. It needs to hit the ball, not push the ball. So I thought maybe I can add some springs so I can preload some energy. But I think I need to put it in the case to see how the ball reacts to it.
After testing very briefly if this would work, it was obvious that it wouldn't. So I set out to design a new mechanism that didn't rely on high amounts of energy as much, but that still managed to hit the ball well. This is what I settled on, with this large beam attached to the motor and this small beam attached to the flipper. This allows for fast movement without the need for gears. And as you can see, this allows for enough action during the game and assures you will actually be able to score some points high up.
So now that we've got the core functionality, I'm gonna start fleshing it out a little, making it a bit more complete. And then I'm gonna start thinking about the design. So I also have this tablet and I thought it would be nice to have this installed inside of the machine so that we could display the score on this nice big screen instead of just these tiny Mindstorm screens. Furthermore, I'm also going to have to install this phone for the AI. This phone can look at the field and tell the robot where the ball is.
I measured how high the phone needed to be in order to see the field and integrated the tablet into the wall. Then I thought about how I could build the phone onto the back without it looking ugly, and I figured I could probably add a little sign with some text onto it to hide the phone behind. And thus, I decided to write the short word SCORE to complete the look of the pinball machine. So now let's move on to the gameplay with these centers and this circle and these random cones and some tubes, why not? And the hopper and this dome, a Lego brick and this dog, especially this dog, yeah. Now we're really nearing the end of this build. I added one game element after the other and gradually worked my way up the board until I arrived at probably the most important part of the board, the dog. I also made sure to include some moving elements to spice up the gameplay and maybe cause some minor frustrations. But without further ado, here is the end result.
I'm really glad with how this turned out, especially since I'm not really known for my design skills, more so the absence of them, but with the build done, it is time to write some code. I've written one main code that has a bunch of things that need to be handled, with three different variants of it for each of the levels of control.
We basically have five things happening simultaneously at all times. The first one is very simple, as it just handles the moving element of the game. It starts and stops the spinning circle in the middle, and opens and closes the trapdoor on the right side periodically.
So this is peanuts, we shouldn't talk about it too much.
The second thing that's happening is the checking of the Mindstorm sensors. These three sensors need to be checked at all times, so that we can register 100, 200 and 300 points being scored. Furthermore, this part keeps track of the time since the last score, and gives double the points if you score again within 5 seconds.
Now that's a great deal in my opinion.
And third, to display the points on the tablet, I'm hosting a website on my laptop that I can visit on the tablet. I made this nice design with some help of ChatGPT, and it even keeps track of the high score. And in manual mode, you can use it to start a new game.
But when do you start a new game? Well, when your game over. But how does the robot know if your game over? That's where the camera comes in, which is the fourth part.
The camera is always tracking the ball by filtering out all of the non-red pixels and highlighting the biggest area left.
When the ball is in the field, great, no problem there, keep it up. But when the ball is in the plunger area, oh no, game over.
This pops up a button to restart so that you can try to beat the high score again.
Yeah, okay, immediate, no, no, no.
And this leaves us with the final part, which is about control. And for this, I wrote three different variants. Now, for the ultimate test at the end of this video, I'm going to play 10 games with each of them and pick out the best game for each one.
Starting with the first one, which is full manual control. If you press left, flip left. If you press right, flip right. Simple enough.
The next one, however, is getting more advanced. For this one, I wrote a bot that uses the coordinates of the ball to control the flippers, and it looks like this. First, we predict where the ball is going to be in the near future using the position and speed of the ball.
Then, if this position is near any flipper, flip the ball, get it away as far as possible from here. It may not be the best strategy, but it works, and that's enough. This leaves us with the final and probably most anticipated one. I'm going to attempt something that I've never seen before on the internet with Lego. I'm going to create a neural network that is going to play hundreds of games and learn how to play from those games. And it looks a little like this.
We input the coordinates of the ball, the speed of the ball, and the last action it did into this model. Then we have some hidden layers that do some calculations on those values, and the results of these calculations lead to a number that can be 0, 1, 2, or 3. And these numbers represent the actions the robot can take. So we do these actions and see what happens, and then we give rewards and punishments to rate these moves. We could, for example, give rewards for making the ball move up or scoring points, and give punishments for losing the game. Now that we've rated the action, we go back and tweak some values in the hidden layers and try again, hoping to score more points. All of this happens in real time for hundreds of games, starting completely random and moving more and more towards a stable model.
Speaking about those games, by the way, we better get started training the model, because this is going to take a while. And just for you, I even cooked up a song to go along with it with the help of ChatGPT and Udio. Enjoy!
Lego bricks, wire slippers, little tricks, taught how to play the game. At first is bad, who's to blame? All those left of all those right, but just misses every fight. Fix the code, give it a spin, and this time round it's gonna win. Spinball, but just flexible, keep it under play ball. And makes the score better each time than before. Brickbot wins, it's his day. A champion built the league away.
Spinball, but just flip the ball. Keep it up, don't let it fall. Train each day, you'll win someday. Spinball, but we're on our way.
Well, that took a while. It wasn't my first attempt either, by the way. I had like 8 different models before this that were just slightly different, and it all just took so long to train. But we finally have a model. Luckily though, I only had one casualty.
So I took these out, and yeah, they just completely snapped in half. When I lift this, like, oh, that smells so bad. This left motor is completely burned for some reason.
Yeah, this one just refuses to turn. Yeah.
I may have lied. There were 2 casualties.
We needed to be more explosive. Like that. It smells like gunpowder now.
Yeah, well, I changed the code a bit to use less energy, and now it's all working great. As I said, I played 10 games with each method and picked out the best game for each. So without further ado, here are the final games.
Game number 9 now. Really getting close to the end. I need to start scoring some points. Okay, that's 100 points. Start off. Always nice. Okay, I was scared there. And another no. Okay, that was close. That was close. Come on.
No!
This one, surely. Yes, 200 points. And another 400 points. 700 now. Match the high score. This needs to be the one. Go on. Get it away here. Yes, 200 points. Get it away. No, not like that. 2 watts points. Okay, 200. This is 1100. Come on, this is the one. 1300. Another one. 1500. Oh no, this is okay. That was close. 1800. I don't even know. 2400. Okay. Crazy high score. This is the one. Oh.
3000.
Yeah, that is definitely my personal high score.
Well, let's take a look at how the computer and the AI hold up, because this is going to be a tough score to beat.
Game number 9, I think. Thank you.
So unfortunately, the AI wasn't able to beat me at pinball. But hey, it's my first attempt at creating an AI, so I'm happy I even got it to work. Well, there's only one thing left to do. Thank you for watching. Oh, and there's also liking and sharing. Please share this video if you want others to see this.